Welcome to Mishnah Study. Masechta Shekelim, Perek Chet Mishnah Bet. Up here in this Mishnah, we're going to discuss vessels that are found in Jerusalem. So, kol hanikelim hanimtzaim b'Yerushalayim, derech yirida lebet ha'tevila tmeim, derech aliyah tehorin. Right. So, all utensils or vessels that are found in Jerusalem, if they're on their way down to the mikveh, right, to the bet ha'tevila, which is the mikveh, then they're considered tameh. If on their way, it's on their way up from the mikveh, then they are tahor. Right, as the Mishnah says, shelo kiridatan aliyatam. So what does this mean? So Harambam explains that the way they go down, they don't come up in the sense, right, of how they are recognized, right, from the way the vessel is resting or the way it looks, right? People are able to know and differentiate whether it was on its way down to the mikveh and it's still tameh, or if it's on its way up from the mikveh and it's still tahor. That's Harambam's Perush. I do want to quote Bartunura's Perush, just because it's close to home, and that is, they found an ancient mikveh in Gush Etzion, right near Alon Shvut. It's on Derech Avot, right, and it really dates back to the Second Temple period. And what's interesting is, way Bartunura explains the Mishnah, as he says, Derech Yirida Lebet HaTivla, he says there are two paths to the mikveh. One that went down, be'ahad yordim, one people went down to the mikveh, be'ahad olim, and the other path, people came up. She'lo yigiu ha'tameim ba'teorim, so the people who are tameh don't touch the people who are ta'or. V'shel derech yirida v'adai tameim, lefi sh'naflu miyad ha'meviim la'tevila, right? And if it's on the way down, it's for sure tameh, because it fell from the people who are on their way going down to bet ha'tevila. Now look at this picture. This is from Derech Avot, mikveh found in Derech Avot. And you can see on the right, there's a path that goes, this way they would go down on the right, and then you come back up on the left, right? So the way Bartunas explains it is, if you find a vessel on the right side, on the steps going down on the right, that would be considered tamer. On the way up, on the left, that would be considered tahor, right? So that's the way Rabbi Mobadiah explains it. Again, a little different than Harambam. That's according to Rabbi Meir. Different Rabbi Meir, that depends if it's on the way down to the mikveh or it's on the way up from the mikveh. Rabbi Yose Omer, kulam tehorim, they're always tahor, chutz min asal ve'amagrefa ve'ameritza, ha'myuhadim la'kevarot. Except for these three items, which, because of the functionality of these three things, right? It's a basket, they would hold, atzamot, would hold, bones. Magrefa is a rake, right, that they were used to rake the bones of the people, dead people. Umritza, right, that they were used also to crush, right, to crush bones in order to put them into the basket, to take them from place to place. That's actually drawn from the word vataritz et gulgulto, right? This is from the story where the woman throws down the stone on the head of Avimelech, and it crushes his skull, right? Vataritz et gulgulto. And because of the humratum atam, because its essence is tameh, so they have a hazakah that they're tameh, right? Those items, we're going to assume that they are tameh, and halacha is like Rabbi Yoseh, right? Because we have the principle that lo gazru al kelim b'Yerushalayim, we do not have a gezerah on vessels in Jerusalem, but outside of Yerushalayim, kol hakelim nisaim b'chazkat tum'ah, shemehem midras zav o tmim b'emet, v'zo gezerah midivrehem. Right, but outside of Jerusalem, we do have the gezerah, because we worry that it may be a tameh midras or tameh met, and that's how Harambam ends off this Mishnah.